Hi, in this video I'm going to compare the sound of a real bass versus the sound of two bass virtual instruments. So let's go! So around a month ago I got an email from Plugin Alliance announcing their new bass virtual instrument called WedgeForce Keemon. And this promised to contain all latest bass virtual instrument technology, so I was kind of curious about how it sounded and I wanted to compare it to my real bass behind me here. And in addition, I decided to also include another bass virtual instrument called Easy Bass by TuneTrack, which I believe is a pretty popular choice currently. Now, if you use all bells and whistles of these virtual instruments, you can probably make them sound pretty decent, but I was wondering about really just the basic sound of them. So for the real instrument, I recorded my Fender Roadworn P-Bass through the Red DI, which is tube DI, going into my A-Design Specifica preamp, and then going to my RME converters. So just the DI sound, but going through some pretty nice equipment. So for the bass virtual instruments, I really also tried to select a very basic sound, P-Bass if available, and just DI, no amp tones, no effects, etc. Now usually these bass virtual instruments have lots more, so I'm definitely not using all features of these bass virtual instruments. Let's have a look at the two I used. So forget about the blue tracks for now, because those are the exports of the bass instruments. But over here you can see the virtual instrument track with the WedgeForce Keemon virtual instrument, so let's open it. And as you can see, it's actually the model of a P-Bass. It's quite basic. If you look at the manual, you see that how they're different is that at the heart of the Massive and Authentic Tone is our proprietary synthetic force engine, which somehow makes sure that there are different harmonic resonances for each combination of notes that you're playing. And that's why they're calling it the synthetic force engine. They have no built-in effects, so you need to use other plugins for that, but they do have customizable pitch bending or sliding, a customizable velocity map, customizable behavior of the sustain pedal, and you can play notes outside of the guitar neck. So very, very basic. And I've also set this up quite basic. So I've set the playing style to fingers warm, because that's what I've been using on my Fender P-Bass as well. Everything has been left to default. Even the neck fretting positions were pretty accurate for the lick that I played, which is a very simple lick actually, because I also need to be able to play it on real bass and I'm not a bass player. The sustain pedal, well, I'm not using the sustain pedal, so this setting doesn't really matter. The picking I've set to auto artificial intelligence, sort it out yourself. Bending, I'm not using bends in this lick. And the polyphony I've set to 1, so that only one bass note sounds at the same time, which is quite okay for the groove that I'm playing. Now, when we're talking about the groove, this is the MIDI for that. So I've tried to add the MIDI notes in such a way that it's very much in sync with what I'm playing on real bass. And I also varied the velocities a bit to make sure that it's not just one level, but that you actually get some movement in the same way that you get on the real bass. So if we shortly listen to that, this is how the groove sounds on the WedgeForce Keemon. And then it repeats. So like I said, quite simple. Now, as for Easy Bass, you see that I don't have MIDI on the Easy Bass track, and that's because the MIDI is inside the virtual instrument itself, which gives a few more options to add some articulations, which WedgeForce Keemon doesn't have, but Easy Bass does have these articulations. But first of all, you're also seeing, well, what I think is meant to model a Fender bass. I think this is modeling a Fender Jazz Bass, so it's not a P-Bass, like the real bass that I'm playing or the other virtual instrument. Now, if you now go to the grid editor, you can see details of the MIDI, and for example, these two notes, I actually played them with a hammer on, and you can see that you can also set this articulation in Easy Bass. And same for these two notes, for example, which gives it a more authentic hammer-on sound. So let's also shortly listen to this groove. Yeah, so same groove, similar instrument, but with a slightly different sound, of course, because it's a jazz bass. Now, the rest of the features in Easy Bass I'm not using. They have all kinds of grooves that you can use if you want to generate bass lines. You can have accompanying bass MIDI. You can even bass your bass track on a real bass track. And they have lots of different sounds, including amp sounds, but I'm just using the clean DI sound. Now, I exported both instruments to audio here, and then I level matched them to make sure that they sounded similar in loudness. So let's compare them. So I'll first let you hear just the bass without any drums. Here we go. Okay, and next I will let you listen to these instruments with a drum track in there. So I will solo the feet, the drums, so they will sound whichever bass I'm soloing at the time. And obviously this will slightly mask the sound of the bass, so the question is, how real does it sound in this case? So what did you think? Which track did you find fitted best for this groove? Let me know in the comments. Now for me, the real bass track sounded much more alive. You really hear all the little finger noises and slides and all that, and they're different every time. And that just adds that human element and character to the groove. Although really, if you don't want this in your production, a real bass player may have been able to reduce those sounds a bit. Now as for Easy Bass, it's a slightly different sound, of course, from the Fender Jazz Bass. I did tone down the tone knob a bit to make it sound a bit more muffled and with a bit more low end, but obviously you're never going to get there completely. But what I did like a lot about the Easy Bass sound is that it sometimes also added some of those noises that you get when playing a bass guitar. Specifically the fret buzz I heard quite clearly, especially on that low G note, the first note of the phrase every time. And the nice thing about it is that it was not done every time, it was not the same every time. So it did add some variation in the same way that you would get if a real bass player played the track. Now the sound character of the Wedge Force Keemin was much more like my P-Bass, I feel. And that's probably because they're actually modeling a P-Bass. But it did lack a bit in those variations for me. And also it's not really possible to add any articulations like the hammer-ons, which I feel made a big difference in the track played by Easy Bass. Now if you somehow found this video useful or entertaining, please give it a like for the algorithm, subscribe to the channel, and ring the little bell icon so you know when I post another video. And if you want to support the channel in a different way, I also have affiliate links in the description. So if you want to buy anything in these stores, you can do so after clicking on the affiliate link, and I'll get a small commission without any extra cost to you. Now the next video up here is my video on how to separate kick and bass in a mix. So have a look, enjoy that, and see you soon.